My name is Billy. I'm a cat. That's in case you were wondering. So where does my story begin? Well, in 1999, my mother had a litter of three. Two of the kittens were sold. One of them went on to become my father. Yeah, my father is my brother. Confusing, right? And kind of weird if you think about it. In 2001, I was born into a litter of six. The only problem with that is all my brothers and sisters were ginger. They had red hair. Unlike me, who was grey and white. And my mother wonders why I have trust issues. As time goes on, my brothers and sisters, they all get adopted. One by one by one, they've walked out the door with families. But no one seems to want me. I just didn't have the same charm as my brothers and sisters. That's until one day, when a family of four took me in. I guess you could say, the rest is history.
Puss, puss, puss.
My owners would argue with me, but I'd say that I'm the best security this place has had. Who needs dogs when you have a domestic house cat? Just kidding. That was a terrible joke. But if I was to be completely honest with you, I pretty much follow a routine, a scheduled routine. It hasn't changed in over, I'd say, 11 years. Pretty much since I was born. The routine My routine usually starts in the morning. I usually start my day out with a good run around the yard. Okay, enough with the jokes. I sleep in pretty much every day.
Simon Wood, and welcome to Oz News, the 24/7 weather broadcast.
This evening, we interrupt your program to bring you a severe weather warning for the east coast of Australia. Our radar has picked up Cyclone Fucking Runner on the east coast of Australia. It is scheduled to hit the Gold Coast and Brisbane by 7 p.m. this afternoon. We give the idea that you should tie down all loose items, bring your cars inside, and make sure that all pets, yes, all pets, are indoors at all time. I'm Simon Wood. Don't forget that. We'll see you later.
My owner heads off to school. School? That's a harsh invention the humans have to teach young children life skills. Lucky for us cats, we are born with all common knowledge, so school is not really required. Things change in the afternoon. Mornings are usually relaxed. See, my owner brings over a friend, usually, and they get up to some weird things which are more for worse than for better. You can be the judge. If you close your eyes, the pain will disappear. I can't stand happy things. They make me absolutely cringe. However, that's not to say I'm bitter in any way. My happiest times are the ones when my owner opens the door and I'm finally allowed outside. Oh, there's no better feeling. There's nothing I love better than to go outside and explore. But there's only one problem with that. You see, there's one thing I promised myself I would do before I die. And that's to get over the back fence. It haunts me. What's on the other side? Well, that's the question, isn't it? I imagine there'd be so many things for a cat to do. So many places to explore. So much to see and smell and feel under my feet. Oh, how I imagine it. How lovely it must be. Let's see, what do I imagine? I'd imagine there'd be lots and lots of rocks, you know? Yeah, rocks. And there'd be trees. Oh, so many trees. And my owner would be walking around looking at it. And she'd be loving it. There'd be water and rocks with water going over them. And there'd be a waterfall. A huge waterfall with a massive log in the middle. Heck, there'd be water at the bottom. It'd be a pool. It'd be exciting. It'd be fun. It'd be just a dream. And that's what it'll always be. Just a dream. One day I'll get over it. But who knows when this one day might come. For now, I'll just go back to being a cat. How it should be. Simon Wood was right. The hurricane did hit the east coast of Australia, exactly as he predicted. It had winds of over 300 kilometers per hour. It destroyed homes, threw trees around like sticks, and brought floods, huge floods. It was insane. We were lucky to live through it. But there's not much more to my life. It's just routine by routine, day by day, just imagining trying to get over the fence. So I guess I'll say my goodbyes now. So please enjoy this final footage of the storm. After all, it was a cracker. And there you have it, the story of a domestic house cat. Not much to it, is there? Thank you.
puss.
And just like that, I ran away forever. Ha! Just kidding. Could you imagine? I get free food at this joint. I mean, not gonna lie, I went and explored, but I came back. I mean, I'm love there. Although, I must admit, it's good to be free. There's three things that a house cat would ask for. Food, love, and, on the odd case, a little bit of freedom.
Wake up.
Go. Walk towards the fence.
I'm gonna lay down.
All right, go.
All you're gonna see is her head.
That looked shocking.
Sam.
Let go. Run.
He's got a ball!
Billy!
Wait. Recording now.
Good. Audio on.
How's that for audio?
I'll just be like...
I recorded that.
Get everything ready. Can you even see him? Is he in shot? Tasman.
What?
Get him down.
It won't!
I forgot this is his movie, not mine.